time for the official show. Hey, hey, hey. The official show on the radio. Effectual.com. The Effectual Show.
What's going on, good peoples?
Yo.
It's your boy Jeremy J. Smooth Clemens.
And it's your boy Joshua Jeter, aka Sexy Chocolate.
Oh yeah, so we coming at y'all today, and you are now tuned into The Effectual Show with WGIV Charlotte, which is the soul of Charlotte.
Oh yeah, we got a good show for y'all tonight. Very thought-provoking show.
Oh, but yeah.
Before we get started, like always, we got to pay honor to Christ, who is the head of our life.
Yeah, man, that's mandatory, because we wouldn't be nothing without him, man.
Nothing at all.
You ain't lying about that, man.
Yeah, like I said, we got a very thought-provoking show. You know, we're going to turn these questions over to our listeners, too. Y'all make sure y'all go to our Facebook page, The Effectual Show, and tune in, and make sure y'all communicate with us, because we want to get y'all's opinion on these questions too.
Oh yeah, we got two today for them, right?
Yeah, we got two of them, man. We got one from a female and one from a male, so we get both perspectives tonight.
Oh yeah, both sides of the spectrum.
So yeah, we're gonna answer these to the best of our abilities. I'm gonna go ahead and say it. I'm gonna say it right now while I can. All this is just advice. Hey man, you certified?
Not by the system, no.
Not by the, at the same time, really? We both been through some stuff.
What?
You know, we give pretty good advice, I must say.
Come on, nah.
So if you listen to our advice and take heed to our advice, and it don't work out, all in all I'm saying is you can't sue us.
Oh yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? But you know, like I said, I think we give good advice. I just take it for what it is.
Oh yeah, and also too, tonight we are going to announce what the effectual giveaway is going to be for this month.
Yeah, our monthly giveaway. So, y'all make sure y'all stay tuned in to The Effectual Show here on WGIVCharlotte.com. That's the soul of Charlotte. We'll be right back, y'all.
For one night, I'm the man in your life, and we do the things that lovers do. All the loving you like, I give it to you just right. There's nothing less than special when it comes to you. See, what we have is an understanding that works so well for how we are. 'Cause neither of us has the heart to fall in love all over again. No,
I'm not your man, and I know you're not my girl, but it's just that. It's that like way tonight. I know you're not your friend, and I guess I'm too, but it's just that.
About you is that you're always so cool and comfortable whenever I'm around. You're someone that I can talk to no matter what I'm going through. I call on you 'cause I know you'll always be down. See, what we have is so incredible that we'll never find in anyone else. This thing that we share is so unbelievable that I want you all to myself. Sacred lives, and we don't keep time. me.
What's up, y'all? Y'all already know who it is. It's your boy Joshua Jeter, aka Sexy Chocolate.
And it's your man Jeremy J. Smooth Clemens.
And we are back. You are still tuned into the Effectual Show here with WGIVCharlotte.com. So, of Charlotte.
Oh, yeah.
And we're going to go ahead and dive right into these good old questions, man.
Let's get it.
So, this first question we got from a listener, the title of it is Boyfriend Not Romantic.
Uh-oh, nah.
Come on now. You got to have romanticism in a relationship, seem like.
Come on now.
Let me go ahead and read this.
Yes, sir.
I've been with my boyfriend now for a year. He's very attractive and is a perfect gentleman. However, he's not the romantic type.
Uh-oh.
I've never received any flowers or any special gifts just because. Seeing my other friends' boyfriends getting them things kind of makes me feel a little jealous in a way. Should I mention this to him or not? And if so, how?
Well, from your response, it seems like you being romance, receiving flowers or just kind gestures, that means something to you. You mentioned it, you brought it up. So in that case, ultimately, it could be a factor in your relationship. So I would definitely, a relationship ultimately is the both parties are supposed to equally give each person what they need. So you mentioned it. So it sounds like you may possibly need that extra. You may need some type of romance, you know what I mean? So in that case, I would mention it due to if you don't and you just continue to, although he's the perfect guy, if one person randomly gives you a flower or do something, now that could switch the game up. Now he's giving you something that your man ain't giving. So from there, it could get you second guessing or thinking about different stuff or maybe even
tarnish your relationship.
Yeah. So, I would mention it to him, and how I would just let him know, like straight up, like, hey man, you are awesome. At the same time, you can ask him, hey, what's your views on men giving women gifts, stuff like that, and then whatever he say from there.
I like that.
Yes, sir. So he can respond different ways. So then whatever, however he responds, you say, okay. He'd be like, yeah, ultimately as a woman, it may not be necessarily required. At the same time,
it's an extra push.
Yeah, I personally enjoy when a man gives me a gift or when he's romantic, when he's doing that special type of stuff. So if you telling him like that, ultimately him as a man, his duty and obligation should be to fulfill your needs. So if you let him know like that, then he'll say, okay, so this is the problem. So now it's time for me to fix it. So if you enjoy gifts, you enjoy, you know what I mean, you feel special and all that stuff when you gifts are received, then ultimately it should click in his mind to go ahead and do that stuff and go ahead and give you gifts and stuff. So of course from there, if he don't, then you can either choose to continue to be with him or just let him know ultimately my needs ain't being met. You nice, you're a great guy at the same time. I don't believe we'll work ultimately.
Yeah, because like you said, I think both parties need to be equally happy.
Oh yeah.
It's not 50-50, it's 100-100.
Yes, sir. That's it right there, man.
So I definitely feel you with that, man. You pretty much summed up the question and answered it for him, man.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. But I got a flip side question though.
Okay. What's that?
Is it okay or should a girl give a man gifts just because?
I don't see no issue with that due to, as you mentioned, it's both 100-100. So I know myself, you know what I mean? I pretty much like certain stuff. I know I like food, you hear me?
Who don't, man?
Hey, like food, like music, you know what I mean? So I enjoy, you know what I mean, getting stuff too, you know what I mean, every once in a while. At the same time, I'm not required to have Jack.
Right.
So
if
I don't ever receive nothing, you know what I mean, it's not a complete need. Like I have to receive the gift.
Yeah, that's not necessarily one of your biggest check off list items. She has to give you gifts.
Right. I just say it's a cherry on the top pretty much.
Got you. It's extra.
Absolutely.
I got you. Yeah, I feel the same way, man. Like you said. And then and the gifts, like, you know, some guys, they want to come home with a new watch on the bed or something like that.
Right.
If you come home, you done, you done fix me a meal, hot meal. Lord, girl.
What? That's strong, man.
I come home and you say, sit down, baby. Take your shoes off and your socks. Like, you start rubbing my feet?
What?
I'm going to try not to kick your mouth because it might tickle.
But, you know, just, action.
You know, yes, sir, that reaction. But, yes, I mean, yeah, I feel that, you know. But, yeah, I'm with you. It's not necessarily a full force requirement for me. At the same time, it is a cherry on top. So, yeah.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I know a lot of guys, like you said, on the flip side. I know for me, myself, yeah, it don't take much. You know what I mean? I don't gotta have no.
At all.
I don't gotta have jack. It's just a thought that counts. You know what I mean? So, I mean, some women are like that. At the same time, some women want more stuff. But it sounds like you just want something. You know what I mean? So
it's like you just want a box of chocolates on Valentine's Day.
Come on,
you be
now.
Happy.
Hershey Kisses on. So yeah, so. Yeah, I'd definitely bring it up to him, and then from there you can just move forward from there.
Oh yeah. Again, this is just our advice. You know what I'm saying? We not certified, we not licensed, we ain't got our degrees in this. We giving y'all straight up experience.
Yes, sir.
And life values that we've learned. So you can take it and do whatever you want to with it. But ideally it works out for you good.
Absolutely.
So right now we're gonna go ahead and announce this good old giveaway for this month of July. For the Effectual Show, the monthly giveaway.
The Effectual Giveaway.
Oh yeah. So this month we're gonna give away a $50 gift card to another one of our favorite spots in Charlotte.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, it works at any restaurant as long as, you know, the restaurant exists in any state or city.
Absolutely.
But $50 gift card to Maggiano's, A Taste of Italy.
That's it.
Man, that's some good food there now.
You ain't lying. Especially you can get that combo. You get the meal, and then you get a to-go, too. Full meal to-go. What?
Man, whoever thought of that?
Man.
And the price is reasonable.
Man, what?
For that, you can get, if you use that gift card right, $50, you can get about 6-7 meals off of that, boy, by getting that.
Man, it's making me want to send a quick email up in there for real. No, fake name.
What?
My name is Jeff Johnson.
Jeffrey. My name is Will Camps.
For real. Send them the email. I win in action.
Yes, sir.
But yeah, so to win, what you have to do is next Wednesday, the first person who sends us an email at 10:10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to effectualgiveaway@gmail.com. And that's effectualgiveaway.com. So the first one who sends us an email at 10:10, not before 10:10, but 10:10 or later. So the first one who's the closer to 10:10, that's who will receive that gift card. So what you have to do when you send us that email, just pretty much write your name and write your telephone number to be contacted. And we'll contact you and arrange for it to be delivered to you.
Oh, yeah. Y'all, you know, so make sure you at your computers at 10:10 or your cell phone, your tablet, however. Send in that good old email to get this $50 gift card to Maggiano's.
Oh, yeah. And that's next show, next Wednesday.
Next show, yeah.
10:10.
So, yeah, y'all make sure y'all stay tuned for that. We're going to go to another break here on The Effectual Show. It's your boy Joshua Jeter, a.k.a. Sexy Chocolate.
And it's your man Jeremy J. Smooth Clemens.
And we'll be right back.
Girl, I know this might seem strange, but let me know if I'm out of order for stepping to you this way. See, I've been watching you for a while, and I just gotta let you know that I'm really feeling your style. Cause I had to know your name, and leave you with my number. And I hope that you would call me someday. If you want, you can give me yours too. And if you don't, well, I ain't mad at you. We can still be cool,
girl. I'm not trying to pressure you. Just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend.
No,
I just wanna know your name. And maybe sometime we can hook up. Hang out, just you.
Damn, I'm surprised that you called. Cause the way you walked away, I thought I wasn't gonna see you no more. Since you didn't wanna give me your man, I thought that you were digging me and wasn't digging me. But anyway, what you doing tonight? I'll probably be with my peeps. If it's cool with you, maybe we'll swing by. You can just chill, oh, you can just chill with me. Long as you're comfortable and you feel secure when you're with me. Cause
I'm not trying to pressure you, just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend.
Oh yeah,
I just wanna know your name. And maybe sometime
going on, good people. We are back. And it's your boy Jeremy J. Smooth Clemens.
And it's your man Joshua Jeter, aka Sexy Chocolate.
And you are now tuned into The Effectual Show with WGIV. So we're back at you, coming at you. And we got another question on them, as we mentioned.
Oh, yeah, man.
Yes, sir. So this question, here we go. Hey, what's going on, Effectual? I've been single for a while now, but have been actively dating multiple women.
Mm-hmm.
The dates are cool, but they are adding up financially since I pay for everything on the dates. Should I be paying for everything on my dates?
That's a good question, man. In today's society, it seems like it is required for the man to provide and pay for everything from the gate, out the gate.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think to me personally, you know, I'm at the same time, I am the type of person, I am the type of guy that does pay usually for everything on the date. At the same time, I sure wouldn't mind. Say we go get dinner in the movies. Okay, I got your dinner. You know what I'm saying? I pay for dinner. We go to the movies. I pay for the ticket. I'm with it. I can pay for the movie ticket too. But you trying to get popcorn and drinks and candy and all that stuff, I think you can fork that at yourself.
So it's a limit. So pretty much you got the main courses, but all extra action that gotta be on her.
I mean, that's, yeah, all ultimately. Yeah.
Understood, yeah. I see what you're saying on that. I mean, I know I'm engaged now, you hear me?
Congrats.
But I know, yeah, I appreciate it, man. I know when I was in the dating game, in the dating scene, arena, ultimately I know if I did go on dates and everything, ultimately I always came prepared,
right,
just in case to pay for everything. So that just in case if I had to pay for everything, then ultimately I'm prepared to do so at
right.
the same time. I'm not opposed to the female paying for her action too. So we did go out to eat You know what I mean? If I paid for my meal, she paid for hers. You know what I mean? I don't see no issue with that. So right,
especially, you know, if it's a date and y'all not even exclusive, you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, because dating is getting to know the person. So,
it's pretty much an active part on each part. Like, it's a, what I'm trying to look for. It's a, I guess in a way it's benefiting both of y'all.
Right.
Like,
so, it's
like, yeah, the guy maybe asked you out. He's wanting to get to know you. At the same time, it's a chance for the girl to get to know the guy.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's
like equal, you know, equal reciprocation, honestly.
Yeah, so that mutual interest type thing. So yeah, so I mean, I know some of the girls, they may want you to pay for everything. They believe they don't care about nothing. If you're going on a date, you gotta pay. At the same time, some are open and understanding in regards to they'll pay for their meal or whatever y'all do as a date, you pay for your actions. So in regards to you being, should you pay for everything, I mean, I leave it open due to some girls will pay for their own stuff. But what I will say this, I know in regards to it's adding up financially. So when you going on these dates, you can just start doing other things. You don't have to go to no expensive restaurant for no date. You can wait to do that stuff when you are exclusive. So you can just go to the park, go chill, go get some ice cream. Let's do random different stuff. Go go play miniature golf. Do stuff that doesn't require a lot of cash flow. Since you say you dating multiple women. So in that regard,
women.
Oh, really? So in that regard, I would try to get the most for the less. Yeah. The least, in other words, until you're exclusive. So
I feel that. So yeah, like if you do, yeah, I feel that, man. There's a lot of inexpensive dates to go on that are powerful. That
go to a dessert shop, get some dessert, $5 dessert.
Go walk on I know here in Charlotte, they got the boardwalk or they got different parks out here. It don't cost nothing to go to a boardwalk or walk on the boardwalk or walk through some parks. I mean, you're getting the nature scenery. Shoot, go to Food Line or Walmart, grab you 2 loaves of bread, some peanut butter, some jelly, some chips. Got your little picnic.
Come on, now.
That's, you know, girls love picnics. What? So, yes, I mean, yeah. So, I mean, you might have to, like you said, you might have to change up, you know, your dating, whatever you're doing. You ain't got to take it to, you ain't got to take it to Ruth's Chris on the first date.
Right.
Put like this, too. If you start high, you got to stay high.
Come on, now.
What they said, what it takes to get it, takes to keep it. So, if you start taking it to Ruth's Chris, start out taking it there. Oh, you got to keep that up, brother. You can't go to Ruth's Chris, then go to a picnic.
Come on.
A lot of times it don't work like that.
And a lot of times, if you do start there, you got to have somewhere to build and grow from. So if you start, you know what I mean, there, just make sure you can keep it up and then you can continue to grow from there. So
yeah, so you better start out on them picnics first, brother.
Picnics on them, man.
The picnic.
Understood, nah.
So yeah, man. At the same time, we're gonna turn this question over to the Facebook.
Oh fam. Yeah,
we want to get y'all's input on this. So y'all make sure y'all go to the Effectual Show page on Facebook. Comment your opinions, your thoughts. Let us know what y'all think about this. We want to get y'all's opinions. Should a man pay for everything on dates?
Yes. So at 10:30 tonight, at the close of the show, we're gonna have the question posted. We want to hear your thoughts.
Oh, yeah. Make sure y'all go check this out. Again, this is all just advice. You can do whatever you want to with it, man.
Oh, yeah. And for recap, it's the Effectual Show, TheEffectualShow, and on Facebook.
Yep.
You will see it.
The Effectual Show. Make sure y'all go tune into us, y'all. But we're going to get into some events we got coming up on tomorrow. Tomorrow night, we're going to be at Red 28 in the University area. Every Thursday night, they have Ladies Night. So ladies, bring all your friends and your girlfriends. And fellas, you also are welcome too. Effectual will kick off live music starting at 9 to 11. And from there, the DJ will kick off on the ones and twos playing that old school R&B.
Oh, yeah.
Laid back, chill night. Make sure y'all come check that out.
Yes, sir. And then Friday, we're going to be uptown, y'all. We're going to be at Sydney's Martini Wine and Bar.
Yes, sir.
We're going to be playing some of that live jazz, that live soul, that live pop.
And that live R&B, brother.
Oh, yeah.
And sisters.
Yes, sir.
Make sure y'all come check us out up there. We're going to have fun both nights. You know what I'm saying? If you can't come Thursday, come Friday. If you can't come Friday, come Thursday. If you can come both nights, come both nights.
Oh, yeah. And Friday, it's going to be from 9 p.m. to 12 a.m. And also, too, it's free validated parking. So right beside Cindy's, connected onto the building, you can just park into that parking deck. And from there, that validates your parking.
But to get your ticket validated, you got to bring your ticket inside to Sydney's with you, and they will validate it for you at the front desk.
Absolutely.
But, y'all, we've had fun with y'all. We had a good night. What you say?
Yeah. We did. And we do want to say, if you have any questions that you want us to answer on the show, on the Effectual show, email them to askeffectual@gmail.com, and that's askeffectual@gmail.com. Anything can be about music, business, relationships, life,
professionalism, anything.
Yeah, and we answer them anonymously. And two, if you're interested in a radio advertisement, email us at theeffectualshow@gmail.com. That's theeffectualshow@gmail.com. And we respond and let you know what we have to offer in regards to advertising and promoting on our show station.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And also, just check us out on all social media networks. Check out The Effectual Show, which is this radio show. And also check out our band, Effectual. Make sure y'all check us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. And also check out our YouTube page for Effectual, the band. We're posting weekly video vlogs and different stuff like that. So we can keep y'all, stay in touch with y'all. So make sure y'all go check us all out on all those social media outlets. This has been The Effectual Show here on WGIVCharlotte.com. It's your boy Joshua Jeter, a.k.a. Sassy Chocolate.
And it's your man, Jeremy J. Smooth Clemens.
And we signing off.
Peace.